करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे। All right, so I think it's 2 o'clock and welcome everybody. A very good afternoon, and we hope that you have a lovely day. Kindly mute yourself, everyone. We are starting the session now. Still people are joining. Okay. So today we are going to have a session. Everybody, please be on mute. Okay, I think that is better. So good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to have a session on bilateral coordination activities. So what exactly do we mean by bilateral coordination? Bilateral coordination is the ability to use both sides of the body in a controlled manner and involves a movement of at least 2 limbs. So in very brief, it is your child's or your ability to use both the sides of the body and any 2 limbs. It can be both hands, it can be both legs, it can be 2 limbs together. So let's see few activities today in this session, and I hope active participation from the kids. We have already shared the material with you, and without any further delay, let's quickly start with the session and the activities. So over to Geetu ma'am. You can all please pin Geetu Bhutani's screen. She will be taking over the session.
Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to you all. First, we should know ki bilateral coordination hota kya hai. It refers to the ability to coordinate both sides of the body at the same time, but in a controlled and organized manner. It means ki koi bhi jaye hamare hands ki movement ho ya fir hamare legs ki movement ho, is tarah se coordination ke saath karna कि जिससे जो भी हम टास्क कर रहे हैं, चाहे हैंड से या लेग से, वो टास्क हमारा कंप्लीट हो जाए, दैट इज कॉल्ड बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन। सो इट्स अ फाउंडेशन स्किल। फाउंडेशन स्किल्स हम ये कह सकते हैं कि इट्स अ बेसिक स्किल्स फॉर द डेवलपमेंट। ये डेवलप करती है हमारी कई सारी मेनी मोटर स्किल्स को, इवन ये असेंशियल होती है फॉर हैंड डोमिनेंस के लिए, हमारे ग्रॉस को रिफाइन करने के लिए एंड हमारे फाइन मोटर स्किल्स को डेवलप करने के लिए। इवन ये हमारी पेंसिल ग्रास को इम्प्रूव करती है, हमारी एडीएल की एक्टिविटीज को इम्प्रूव करने में हेल्प करती है, और हमारे कोऑर्डिनेशन को इम्प्रूव करने में, बेटर करने में हेल्प करती है। और एक बहुत कॉमन सा एग्जाम्पल है बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन का, दैट इज जंपिंग जैक्स। वी ऑल नो कि इसमें बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन के साथ ही हम जंपिंग जैक्स को कर सकते हैं। और हम एक और एग्जांपल कुछ से समझे बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन का, दैट इज इरेजिंग। इरेजिंग देखने में तो बहुत सिंपल सी एक्टिविटी लगती है, बट जो हमारा हैंड डोमिनेंस होता है उसमें हमारे इरेजर की कैसे ग्रास्पिंग होती है वो मैटर करती है, और जो हमारा स्पोर्टिंग हैंड होता है उसको हम पेपर को कैसे होल्डिंग करता है बच्चा, उसकी जो मूवमेंट होती है वो मैटर करती है हमारे बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन को ठीक से इम्प्रूव करने के लिए। सो बेसिकली बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन 3 टाइप्स के होते हैं। फर्स्ट है हमारा सिमेट्रिकल मूवमेंट, नेक्स्ट हमारा रेसिप्रोकल मूवमेंट, थर्ड इज आर स्पोर्टिंग हैंड मूवमेंट, और हम कह सकते हैं लीडिंग हैंड मूवमेंट। सिमेट्रिकल मूवमेंट में बेसिकली ये होता है कि चाहे मैं अपने हैंड से मूवमेंट कर रही हूँ या फिर मैं अपने लेग से मूवमेंट कर रही हूँ, बट वो जो मूवमेंट होगी वो दोनों हाथ या लेग्स एक साथ मूवमेंट करेंगे एट द सेम टाइम। जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल रोलिंग, रोलिंग जब भी बच्चा करेगा हमेशा दोनों हाथ से करेगा, दैट इज सिमेट्रिकल मूवमेंट, और ये बायलैटरल के अंडर आता है। या फिर हम जैसे कहें कि जंपिंग, जंपिंग में जब भी मूवमेंट होगी हमेशा दोनों लेग्स की एक साथ होगी, या फिर फॉरवर्ड जंपिंग, ये भी एक गुड एग्जाम्पल है बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन का। अब हम बात करते हैं नेक्स्ट की, दैट इज रेसिप्रोकल मूवमेंट। रेसिप्रोकल मूवमेंट के अंडर जो मूवमेंट्स आती है दैट इज पुलिंग, और या फिर हम कह सकते हैं क्लाइंबिंग अ रोप। इट मींस कि जब भी कोई मूवमेंट होगी मेरा हाथ इस मूवमेंट में है तो जो मेरा दूसरा हैंड होगा वो इस मूवमेंट में होगा, यानी कि कोई भी एक्टिविटी को करते हुए हमारे जो हैंड्स की या लेग्स की पोजिशन होगी वो हमेशा ऑल्टरनेटिंग मूवमेंट में होगी, एक रिदमिकल वे में। हमारा रेसिप्रोकल मूवमेंट, जैसे पेडलिंग है, पेडलिंग एक बहुत साइकिल की पेडलिंग एक बहुत गुड एग्जांपल है बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन का, हमेशा लेग्स की मूवमेंट, ये लेग ऊपर है तो ये लेग नीचे होगा, इस तरह से मूवमेंट होती है। सो नेक्स्ट हमारा है लीडिंग हैंड मूवमेंट। लीडिंग हैंड मूवमेंट कहने का मतलब ये है कि जो हमारा हैंड डोमिनेंस है, जो मेरा मेन काम करने वाला हाथ है, उसके थ्रू जो मैं एक्टिविटी करूंगी और जो मेरा दूसरा हैंड जो सपोर्टिंग हैंड है मेरा, उसको मैं एक स्पोर्ट में स्पोर्ट एज अ स्पोर्टर यूज करूंगी। जैसे मुझे अब पंचिंग करनी है या फिर सीजरिंग करनी है तो मैं अपना काम जो होल्डिंग करेगा, इट इज कॉल्ड आर स्पोर्ट लीडिंग हैंड मूवमेंट। सो व्हाट अबाउट कि बायलैटरल कोऑर्डिनेशन होता क्या है? So, Neha ma'am, that is by
A little about bilateral coordination. So, we will proceed to the activities now. Bachche hamare wait kar rahe hain, all the kids are waiting. Let's start with the activities. So, for the first activity, you will be requiring the bottle. Geetu ma'am, can we start with the activities, please?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
We get a recording later on?
We are recording the session. We will inform you by evening whether we'll be sharing it or not. We are recording the session.
Okay, thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am. I have just one query. If a child is not good in a bilateral activities, so what are the problems that he face in future?
See, a lot of activities, because a lot of things require both hands or both limbs movement. So it can be your ADL, it can be your handwriting, it can be your general coordination, your balancing activities, your eye-hand coordinations, everything will be affected. The midline crossings, bilateral coordinations, your fine motor, gross motor, these are the foundational skills. If these are not right, so the further higher skills obviously will not be developed properly. Okay? So,
and if it, so in that regard, we have to continuously do the bilateral exercises with the kids. So this will help them.
Yes, definitely. We are sharing few activities. There are a lot of activities, and we will be sharing some. I think 6 to 7 here because of the time restraint. If you need more, you can search over the net or you can get in touch with us. Okay. So without any further delay, let's start the activity.
So, हमारी फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी है बॉटल का ढक्कन हम खोलेंगे। टेक आउट ऑल योर बॉटल।
यस किड्स, ब्रिंग द वाटर बॉटल। सी, इट इज द सिंपलेस्ट थिंग दैट वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद। जो सबसे सिंपल एग्जांपल आप बायलैटरल का सोचेंगे वो होगा कुछ भी खोलना। सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद दैट एंड वी विल गो ऑन टू फर्दर डिफिकल्ट वंस। Yes, so,
Abhiraj.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
So, मैंने अपनी बॉटल को इस तरह से होल्ड करना है, इस ये मूवमेंट रख के इसको मैंने इस तरह से होल्ड किया और मेरा जो हैंड डोमिनेंस है उसकी मूवमेंट ये रहेगी, इस तरह से जो मेरा थंब है वो इधर आएगा और जो बाकी सारी फिंगर्स है वो एक साथ रहेंगे और मैं इसको इस तरह से रोल करते हुए।
यस जयश्री स्वामी अविराज, यस वेरी गुड, एंड सम ऑफ द किड्स हैव ओपन एंड दे आर हैविंग वाटर व्हिच इज वेरी नाइस। अमिया ट्राई, यस पूरा वेरी गुड। ओके सो एवरीवन इज एबल टू डू दैट मैम।
Okay, ma'am. So, move. Next activity, ma'am?
Yes. Let's start with the pouring activity.
Okay, ma'am. So, pouring activity ko karne ke liye hame chahiye 2 glasses.
You can take any glass, disposable, steel, plastic, anything will do. 2 glasses.
Green.
and some grains. We'll start with grains first.
So मैंने एक ग्लास में कुछ ग्रेन्स डाल दिए. सो अब इन ग्लासेस को सबसे पहले हमें बच्चे का लेवल अच्छा है तो हैंड्स की मूवमेंट्स हम इस तरह से स्ट्रेट रख सकते हैं. अदरवाइज अभी आप सिर्फ स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं तो बिल्कुल थोड़ा सा डिस्टेंस देते हुए इतनी मूवमेंट यहाँ से ये ग्रेन्स स्टोर कर रहे हैं.
अभिराज, शिमाज, स्वामी, वेरी गुड. अब इस एक्टिविटी में ट्राई करिए कि बच्चा जो है किसी टेबल या उसका सपोर्ट ले बिना इन द एयर होल्डिंग कर.
जब आपको लगे कि बच्चा ग्रेन से इजीली कर पा रहा है तो यू कैन डू विद द
नो दे आर स्टिल डूइंग गीतू मैम एंड सम की
पानी से भी स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं.
पानी एक बार रुक जाइए. सोनिया बेटा यू आर कीपिंग द ग्लासेस ऑन द टेबल. तो अगर बच्चा नहीं कर पा रहा तो आप फ्लोर का या टेबल का सपोर्ट लीजिए. अगर बच्चे की एबिलिटी है तो कोशिश करेंगे कि हाथ दोनों हवा में रहेंगे ताकि आपकी आर्म स्ट्रेंथनिंग भी हो. सो यू नो यू गेट टू नो कि कितनी स्टेबिलिटी है, कितना स्ट्रेंथ है बच्चे की आर्म्स में. और स्पिलेज नहीं होनी चाहिए. जब बच्चा ये कर पाए देन वी गो ऑन टू वॉटर. Yes, may I try? Good. Guru Sai, good. Abhiraj. Agam, yes, do it. Swami, very good. Swami, hold the glasses in your hands, both your hands. Jayashri, okay, you can keep it on the table. You're still small. Pura, very good.
गुरु साईं,
वेरी गुड.
डू इट बेटा,
करके दिखाओ. मैं देख रही हूं
गुरु. वेरी गुड
मैम, शी डूइंग ऑलराइट.
सॉरी आई एम जस्ट कमिंग यू. कैन यू जस्ट.
वेरी गुड
पूरा. ओके ओके. वी
उर्वशी, गुड.
प्लीज मेंशन शानवी.
एक्चुअली नेम इज शानवी.
या ओके शानवी, गुड.
ओके
नाउ Here what we have to another next level would be कि बच्चा जो है आप pouring कर रहे हैं तो देख रहे हैं कि दोनों glasses बिल्कुल साथ साथ में लगे हुए हैं. Both are like together, touching each other. So to go up a higher level, we start increasing the distance between the glasses. And थोड़ा सा distance increase करने की कोशिश करेंगे. Let's increase a little distance.
ऊपर अब डालो, ऊपर से डालो. हाँ, टच नहीं करो, ऊपर से डालो. मैम देख रही है आपसे. हाँ, ऊपर से डालो.
यू सी द टाइटनिंग ऑफ द मसल्स. आप देख रहे हो कि शोल्डर और कोर कितना टाइट हो गया. दिस इज वेयर वी नो कि वहां पे इतना आर्म स्ट्रेंथ, इतना आर्म स्टेबिलिटी नहीं है. Okay, if you see those things tensing in your child's body, it is indicative that we are lacking that strength.
हाँ मतलब तो देर इज सम व्हाट कैन बी डन मैम फॉर दैट स्ट्रेंथ में.
मैम वी विल बी टेकिंग इट अप लेटर. दैट इज अनदर सिनेरियो ऑफ शोल्डर स्ट्रेंथनिंग, कोर स्ट्रेंथनिंग एंड आर्म स्ट्रेंथनिंग. बट टुडे वी विल जस्ट फोकस ऑन द बायलैटरल.
बेड में जुना दे.
बट मैम इफ शी इज जॉइनिंग इट अगेन एंड अगेन तो हाउ टू टेल हर टू मेंटेन.
यू हैव टू रिपीटेडली डू. सो व्हाट यू कैन स्टार्ट विद इज यू कैन जस्ट कीप वन ग्लास ऑन द टेबल. and ask her to pour from a little above. Then let her do from right hand से करवाइए, फिर left से कराइए.
अब डालो.
और फिर हाथ में हवा में लेंगे. इसका scale down करने के लिए प्लीज म्यूट योर सेल्फ. इसका स्केल डाउन करने के लिए पेरेंट्स टू स्केल डाउन द एक्टिविटी फर्स्ट कीप द ग्लास ऑन द टेबल देन ऑन इन द एयर द हैंड्स कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द ग्लासेस एंड द फाइनल वुड बी द आर्म्स कैन बी स्ट्रेट एंड द चाइल्ड कैन पोर प्रॉपरली. ओके सो दिस इज हाउ द लेवल्स विल गो फॉर पोरिंग. पोरिंग इज लाइक वेरी सिंपल एक्टिविटी. वी थिंक दैट द चाइल्ड कैन पोर एंड इट इज डन. But each step will indicate where the strength is lacking. Okay, so all the kids are enjoying pouring. Very good, Abhiraj, Guru, Swami, Shrimaz, Purab, Sonia, Guru, Ritesh.
Ma'am, my son is eating the grains and drinking the water. And instead of pouring, going on drinking and eating the grains.
It is lunchtime, no?
Lunchtime, yes, and secondly, he's having flared up sensory issues.
Okay, no problem. Let's move on to the next activity, kids. Okay, no more eating grains. So, for the next activity, what do we need, Gitu ma'am?
So, ma'am, our next activity, we have to.
Glazed papers or colored paper cutouts. We had asked for 6 colors, right?
Right.
So please tell them the order to be arranged in, Gitu ma'am.
Sure, ma'am. Ma'am, order. First red, then our blue, green, yellow, white, and orange.
Okay, everybody, please arrange in the same order you can see on Gitu ma'am's screen. Okay, Sonia, done with the water. Let's change the activity. Let's bring the colored papers.
Ma'am, I have Shirif. I have only 4 colors.
Oh, no problem. You can keep 4. Okay. And you can just put 2.
How big the sheets have to be?
Just enough so that it can be on your table. Depends on your table size.
A4 size? A4 size?
No. That's huge. We just need a small square.
Okay.
Those who do not have the colored sheets can just simply, you know, take the white sheet and put the crayon just to know for the child that this is the color I'm supposed to touch.
Even you can use beads also or pom-pom also.
Yes. That would be a very good alternative. If you don't have, you can just put any other colored object. Okay, so I see most of the kids are ready with the sheets. Guru, Abhiraj, Swami, ready? Purab, ready? Ready, Ritesh. Okay, let's start with the activity.
So, you have to touch green and yellow. Touch green and yellow.
You have to touch good, them very together. Good together you have to touch so, them, not together. One by one.
Yeah, not one by one.
Okay. Touch green so, and yellow. Okay, done. Good, everybody.
Done. So next, sir, you have to touch red and orange together.
Very good, Swami. Yes, Pura, very good.
Blue and yellow.
Blue and yellow. So you see, the kids, many kids are having problem here because they're not able to keep both the hands together. first one is going and then the other is going. Yes, good.
So touch green and orange.
Green and orange. Very good, Swami. Jayashri. Very nice. Guru.
I think blue side don't have orange pieces.
No problem. No problem. Anything you can keep. And very good.
Yeah. Ma'am, both hands have to go together.
Yes. Both have to go together.
Okay.
Not one by one.
But
do it, Shanvi. Very good. Next command, Gitu ma'am.
Next, you have to touch blue and orange.
Blue and orange.
Together you have to do.
Okay, Swami, not one by one. First, when the child is searching, this is where your mind coordinations also come into play. So you have to quickly search and place both the hands together. Now, Gitu ma'am will give back to back four commands, okay? And you all have to touch.
Okay. So you have to touch red and white. Next is blue and orange.
Next,
green and red.
Next,
yellow and blue. Good, very good, Swami. Good.
Very good, very good. So this is how you can practice. You can even put them on the wall, six colors, and ask them to jump and touch. This is another variation of the activity. Okay, so both the hands have to touch together to whatever two colors you are saying. I think we can just try another right and left hand variation with this one.
Yes.
Okay. Please show the papers again. I'll give the command.
Okay.
Okay, kids. Listen to the command now, okay? This is the second level for the kids who are able to touch two colors together. So right hand orange, left hand yellow. Right hand orange, left hand yellow. Left hand red, right hand blue.
No.
Right hand orange, left hand green. Yes, do it everyone. Very good. Everybody is trying very well. Very good. So this is the other variation you can try with the kids. It also works on your auditory processing activity. So
both hands together, because they put only one hand on one and then the other hand on the other.
It comes with a little practice. So first you will start with only three colors, okay, not with six. Since we're having a group session, we have all abilities together. So we have kept a, you know, medium level activity. For the starting level, start with three colors and then ask them to touch red and yellow, red and blue. So both tapping, or you can simply start with the tapping of hands first. You go on tapping on the table, then you are like, then you put the colors. Once they can do tapping with both hands together, then go for tapping on colors and keep on increasing it. It will come with practice. Okay. Everyone enjoy this activity. Welcome, ma'am. Okay. So let's go to the next one. Join. Everyone is having sets and beads?
Next. Yes, ma'am. Thread and beads.
Okay, Gitu ma'am, please show us the next activity.
Ma'am, how big the beads should be?
according to the child's comfort level. Right now, we are not talking about the size of the beading as we have, again, a mixture that depends on the individual ability.
Beading time. This activity finish, Raj.
So, hame thread chahiye aur beads aur ye hum activity karenge in a standing position.
Everybody get up, get up. The small stool or small chair.
Yeah, good. On a chair or a stool.
You need to yes. stand up on a chair or a stool.
They have to stand up and do it?
Yes, stand up on a chair or a stool.
Ma'am, on the chair?
Yes.
Yeah.
If the child cannot just simply make them stand on the floor.
Khade ho jao. You're supposed to stand.
Those who can, kids, stand on the chair or the stool. Those who cannot, it's okay. You just stand on the floor.
Chair stool leke aayenge. Chair stool pe khade ho.
Okay, Abhiraj, please adjust your camera. Okay, everybody is ready, ma'am. Let's start.
Okay.
So, Mahin, try, yes.
Beads wali activity. Beads
wali. Ma'am, jo mere hand hai, uski movement ye rahegi, position ye rahegi, aur ye bead, ye maine is tarah se haath aage karke karwane hain. और ये कभी कभी होते हैं कि बच्चे यहाँ से करते हैं वो बन नहीं पाती सो आपने यहाँ तक ऐसी मूवमेंट रखनी है और ये डालना
है वेरी गुड स्वामी ट्राई टू कीप योर हैंड स्ट्रेट Abhiraj, very good. Keep your hands straight. So everybody's hand is almost like close to the body and bend. Try to keep the hands as straight as possible.
Yeah.
Yes, try to keep the hands straight. Good, Mahira. Keep the hands straight. Very good, Abhiraj. Abhiraj, are you standing on a stool or a chair? Very good, Chanvi. Mahin, very good. Ritesh, Agam. Agam, do it. Arav, do it. Guru, very good.
Stretch out the hands. Stretch out the hands.
Stretch out the hands. So beading, almost every child is doing well. In the fine motors, this is one of the first activities that we do. So this is an upper scale of beading.
Ma'am, in which hand should they hold the bead and in which hand should there be the lace?
Start with the dominant hand holding the lace and the non-dominant holding the beads. When the child can achieve it, you can reverse it.
Yeah.
Very good, Purav. Now it's coming out very well. So, when the child is just sitting, he is usually able to do it very easily. In standing position, we see hands moving close to the body. Further, when we raise the level, then it becomes further difficult for the kids to maintain the balance and do the beading because the weight of the beads also add on. Very good, Pratesh. Doing very well. Mahin. Mahira, do it. Shanvi, do it. Good. Agam, good. Urvashi, Guru. Guru Sai. Abhiraj, very good. You have made... Oh, you have already put a lot of beads. Very good. Okay. Very good, everyone.
Ma'am, the... To keep them towards their body. So... Do we stretch? We help them with their hands that hold them tight.
See, again, you cannot directly ask. This is like the upscale we are telling. Okay, if the child is not able to keep the arm straight, first start with as much as he or she can keep it away from the body. As the strength will increase, the arms will become straightened. You can also do this on a balance board. If the child can do it on a stationary stool or chair, yeah, then you can move on to the balance board and do the breathing. Very good, everyone. Very good. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, everybody, back to the chairs.
तो बच्चे हैंकी लेंगे शो मी योर हैंकी गुरु साइन सो एम आई ऑडिबल
यस मैम
ओके वेरी गुड पूरब अभिराज माहिरा वेयर इज योर हैंकी माहिरा वेरी गुड शो मी माहिरा महीन वेयर इज योर हैंकी
एवरीबडी हैज इट मैम
ओके मैम सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आपने टेबल पे रखना है हैंकी को इस तरह से ओपन करके मैम प्लीज चेक देन आपने ये कॉर्नर से इस तरह से होल्ड करना है एंड देन यू हैव टू डू लाइक दिस आपने टिप्स को कॉर्नर से कॉर्नर पे इस तरह से हाँ वेरी गुड स्वामी इस तरह से रखना है गुड गुड
एंड देन आई लेट्स जस्ट वेट फॉर दिस स्टेप लेट्स चेक एवरीवन इज डन यस यस
ओके मैम अभिराज गुड
फर्स्ट स्टेप डन एवरीबडी ओके नेक्स्ट फोल्डिंग मैम
नेक्स्ट हमारा ये जो वन हैंड हम यूज करेंगे और ये हमने इस तरह से यहाँ होल्ड किया नीचे से वी हैव टू टच एंड देन ये हमने यहाँ पे रख दिया एंड इस तरह से टिप्स टू टिप्स हमने रखा
यस पूरा वेरी गुड स्वामी वेरी गुड डू इट अमेया डू इट उर्वशी अभिराज शानवी रितेश Arab, try. Very good. Guru Sai, try. Mummy is not doing it for you. You try. Agam, very good. Very good. Very good. And next folding?
Next we have ये जो corner है और ये जो इधर से corner है इनको यहाँ से यहाँ पे रख दिया tip to tip इनके ऊपर रखना है
ये सिखाया हाउ यू डिड दिस स्टेप मैम प्लीज
एंड जस्ट प्रेस
आई थिंक समबडी वाज आस्किंग फॉर अ रिपीटेशन गीतु मैम ऑफ द लास्ट श्योर
दिस कॉर्नर एंड दिस कॉर्नर
यस
इन कॉर्नर्स के ऊपर रखा एंड देन Just press.
Very good, Jayashree. Done. Swami done. Abhiraj, doing it.
Abhiraj, we will hold it. One time more, karna beta.
Shalvi done? Guru Sai done? Purab done? Okay, very good. So we have taken a simple cloth, like a hanky. You can try with other objects. You move to hand towel, bigger towel.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome, beta. Ritesh, show me, beta. Very good. Maheen, show me. Good, Pura. Very good, Guru. Aram, show me, beta. Very good. V.
That's Shanvi.
Agam.
Very good. So, let's proceed to the next activity, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Popsicle one.
Good, Mahina Beta. Yes, ma'am. Popsicles, two popsicles chahiye, ma'am. And some pom-pom.
Okay, everybody, please see Geetu ma'am's screen and take out the required materials. Two ice cream sticks and few pom-poms.
एक इस हाथ राइट हैंड में लेंगे और एक पॉप्सिकल स्टिक को लेफ्ट हैंड में लेंगे एंड इसे इस इन दोनों हैंड्स इस तरह से होल्ड करते हुए दूसरी जगह पे रखेंगे या फिर यू कैन यूज आल्सो अ बाउल.
यू कैन पुट इट इन द बाउल. Yes, everyone try. Very good. Ameya, Swami, very good. Purab, you can try with something else if you do not have pom-poms. No, no, Mama got it now. Shall we try? Ritesh, doing it. Very good. Mahira, do it. Yes, Guru, very good.
Beta, newspaper ko chota chota roll karke bana lo. जिनके पास पॉम-पॉम नहीं है वो न्यूज़पेपर के छोटे छोटे से रोल बना सकते हैं और उन्हें पॉप्सिकल के थ्रू ये एक्टिविटी कर सकते हैं.
ओके, अनदर वेरिएशन पूरब्स मॉम इज यूजिंग. इन केस आपके पास आइसक्रीम स्टिक नहीं है, यू कैन यूज द पेन्स. यू कैन टेक टू पेन्स.
ये
अगम, डू इट. For those who are able to do it on the table, please increase the distance. Let them walk yes. Two, three steps and then transfer the pom-poms.
Very good, Pura. Try, beta, try.
Very good. Agam, yes, very good. Guru Sai, do it. Shanvi, try. Swami, very good. Swami, you can increase your distance of keeping the pom-poms. It's very close. Guru, very good. You can also increase.
Mahira, good.
Ma'am, Deda.
Who is that, Shanti?
Ma'am, she is using in the spoon, that wooden spoon instead of the ice cream sticks. Is it all right?
Yeah. But if you're not able to do with the ice cream sticks, you can go for the flat spoons. But the idea is to use both the hands, but not joined. So not like a tong, but two separate objects. Let's go further.
Both should not touch.
You should. Two separate objects. Any two separate objects, not the tongs for this activity. So disposable spoons, like you're using wooden ones, you can use that. Pencils, you can use pens, you can use. Sticks you can use, skewers, sticks, anything you can use. So further difficulty level can be increased. Keep increasing the distance of the objects to be transferred. If the child is able to do one step, then you can make them walk and put the pom-poms at a certain distance if they can do this first one. Yes, very good.
Hello,
ma'am. Is it necessary to keep the hand straight while doing this activity, or however the child is comfortable?
However the child is comfortable. However the child is comfortable.
Okay.
Very good, Ritesh.
Very good, Purab. Ameya, very good. Swami.
Very good, Guru.
Very good, everyone. I think the first level almost everyone is able to do. So parents, please increase the distance and then make them practice this. If you want to share the videos, you can share with us and we can tell you further corrections as needed. Let's move on to our final activity, ma'am. Okay, everybody. You need to stand up for the last activity.
Just get up. You have to get up. Stand up, everybody. Yeah.
Ma'am, on the chair or on the
floor? No, on the floor. On the floor.
On the floor, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So, aapne apna right hand lena hai or left hand, and you just have to touch. The body posture jo hoga wo bilkul straight rahega.
Hame to ek bhi na kuch touch.
So here we will come to know the balancing issues.
Next, humne left hand, left leg or right hand use kiya and then touch.
Very good, Swami, Pura, Ameya, very good try. Everyone, Mahin, Mahira, very good. Guru, very good. Ritesh, very good. Shanvi, try, very good. Guru Sai, very good. Agam, very good. Urvashi, very good. Arav, do it. Abhiraj, very good. Jayashri, very good. Okay, so first is your right leg and left hand. Then your left leg and right hand.
And then
child should be
balancing problem is there. Am I not posturing
correctly? Child take the foot from the ball.
Sorry, your voice is not clear.
Ma'am, child ka ball ka support le sakta hai khade hone mein.
See, again the same thing, ma'am. If the child cannot balance, so haan, pehle aap uske liye phir aap further scale down pe jaiye ki aap pehle sirf one leg standing karaiye usse. Uske baad hi activity kariye. Iske liye bache ka one leg balance hona thoda sa zaruri hai.
देखो वन लेटर करके मैम को दिख रहा है.
ओके गीतू मैम आफ्टर दैट.
आफ्टर दैट मैम आप चाहे तो ये राइट लेग और ये लेफ्ट हैंड पीछे की तरफ से भी करवा सकते हैं बैक लाइक दिस मैम.
Now you have to go back side. Right leg on the back side, yeah, touch with left hand.
Yeah.
No, Swami, not the same side. Right leg, touch with left hand. Yes, try everybody. Abhiraj, not the same side. Right leg will go back, touch with left hand. Guru, opposite hand. So most of the kids are touching on the back side, they are holding with the same side hand. It is the opposite hand. Yes, Swami. Now it is good. Ameya, yes, good. Purab, opposite side. Yes, good. Okay. So four motions. Now we are going to do them back to back. Okay. Four motions back to back.
मैम शानी रेजिस्टेंस व्हाइल लिफ्टिंग इवन वन लेग अप मतलब शी इज नॉट रेडी टू डू सो व्हाट कैन बी डन.
फर्स्ट यू हैव टू डू वन लेग बैलेंसिंग विद हर सो लेट हर होल्ड हर राइट लेग विद अ राइट हैंड यूजिंग द वॉल सपोर्ट देन स्टैंड ऑन द लेफ्ट लेग होल्ड इट इन द लेफ्ट हैंड एंड यूज द वॉल सपोर्ट ग्रेजुअली विथड्रॉ द वॉल सपोर्ट एंड देन स्टार्ट विद दिस ऑल्टरेशन. Okay, so everybody ready for the four motions together, back to back. Okay, one, two,
one,
two, three, back side, and four. Everyone look at Geetu ma'am's screen, she is doing it for you. Ma'am, one more time, please.
Sure, ma'am.
Let's start the from the beginning.
The front side or back side?
Both sides, ma'am. Front and
okay,
back.
Ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
One. Everybody, let's start with the first. Everybody, one,
two. Three,
and
four.
Yes, good, Ritesh. Ritesh, same side hand is being used. You need to use the opposite side. Swami, do it. Yes, Guru, good. Front side is fine. Do the back side. Guru Sai, yes, very good. Back side, very good.
Ma'am, can you please show what is the correct way for kids to get up from the floor when they sit down? Because for Shandi, she will first stand in the horse position, then take support and get
up. That depends on the body balancing, ma'am. We cannot generalize one thing for all the kids. We need to see a lot of factors, the strengths involved. But Shanvi's weight is a little more. So I think probably because of that, she's first going to the horse position and then standing up.
First she will go into that position and then stand up.
Yes.
Her weight is more and her balancing also, maybe the leg muscles and hands are not that much strong.
So if we expect her to just stand up straight from the ground to, you know, in a standing position, it will be a little taxing for her. So first work on the body balancing and strengthening. Okay. Okay. I think we have a few queries in the chat box. Yes, please, everybody must be hungry. We are done with the activities, everyone. So there's a question from Sonia City. The bilateral coordination activities are okay with these. Yes, the activities that we have shown today, you can easily do with the kids with epilepsy. There is no issue at all. Okay. Any other doubts? We are closing the session now. All right. So everyone, I hope you enjoyed. And Ethan, yes.
I had that.
Yes, ma'am. If there is a during the riding of the bicycle, it is riding the bicycle, but somewhat slowly. So it is a bilateral coordinate.
Absolutely, yes. It is a bilateral coordination.
Ma'am,
hello.
Ma'am, I have a doubt. I have a skateboard. Is there any other activity I can do with the skateboard?
There are a lot of activities that you can do with a skateboard. So the beginning one would be that you make the child lie down on it in a prone position, and then make them, you know, push the skateboard, make them push their bodies forward with the help of their hands, both the hands. And the transferring of the objects can be done on the skateboard. One, you can ask the child to push it with the hands. Other way can be you push it with the legs. And transferring of the object can be done. It can be done on the ramp. It can be used to rotate. So you can keep throwing the objects and the child has to move here and there, balancing and everything. So beginner level, you can start with that.
Okay.
Madam, can I speak right now?
Yeah, sure, please.
Yeah. Amaya is a left-handed boy and I'm trying hard him to use both his hands. But he prefers using only one hand while doing anything. Only in two activities he uses both of his hands. Otherwise, while writing also, he prefers only using his left hand. How to increase his second hand for support?
First, start with very simple activities which involve usage of both the hands. So the first activity that we started was with opening the bottle. You cannot open the bottle with one hand. Okay, so go for beating or lacing, all the activities which, or, you know, eating something, holding in the left hand and he has to eat with the right hand, or holding in the right hand and eating with the left hand. So from the routine, take up activities which cannot be done without the involvement of both the hands. You need to start with first the need activities which he necessarily has to do, and it will become a gradual habit and reminders have to be given. Okay.
I mean, basic activities he is doing, ma'am, like opening the bottle or eating. He is doing it since long, but writing he started just 1 year back. So there I feel that until and unless he uses his right hand, I mean, he's left-hander. So until unless he uses his right hand for support, he is not able to write properly.
Yes.
So there is a big.
So you have to ask him, this is like by asking, so you have to ask him to hold the paper here and you don't hold it for him, because when the paper will flow up, you know, it will move because of the air. Don't hold it for him or don't give him any supportive help, and that will make him put the hand, because he has to, when the page will flow and come over the other page, he will have to stop it. Okay, so gradual reminders will help. It will happen.
It has to be compulsory, so for him.
Yes, it has to be compulsory.
Yes. Ma'am, I have a query.
Yeah,
my child is 3 and 9 months old. My child is 3 and 9 months old. He's mild ASD1. The issue is that whenever he opens a bottle, he does all these small things. But in the writing, he doesn't concentrate. Like if I told him to match the dots, he will not able to match it on the dots. Either he will not see the second dot, he just moved from there and here and like that. He doesn't do the matching properly. And secondly, if I told him to tear the paper, he doesn't do it like this. He tear like this. Every time I show him, ki tear, you have to use your thumb and then make a pressure over it. But he doesn't do. He just tear like this. So how will we make him? And neither he can use the scissor also, because whenever he uses the scissor, his hands are like this. So maybe he has a gripping issue, but he can grip the things very easily. And he has a force also in his hand. So I didn't get what's the problem.
Force in the hand comes from the shoulder and forearms muscle, not from the finer hand muscles. Okay. And for handwriting, we need the handwriting, scissoring, we need the finer muscles. We are shortly coming up with a handwriting program, which I think we'll be launching in July or August probably. So, you get to know a lot of things like how kids learn to handwrite. Handwriting is from the finer muscles, not from the bigger hand muscles. Your grip, your strength is coming from the bigger muscles. You need to work on the finer ones. Actually, you need to work on both. If you work only on the finer ones, your fine motors will be good. But when it comes to activities like, just pouring with arms straight, the child is not able to do. But
yeah,
if you
couldn't put his arm straight. Every time I do it, he does like this. He folds his arm near to his body.
So it is not just about doing the activity. We need to, break it up, dissect it, and analyze where actually the strength is lacking and what all can be done for it. For your question, see, he's still young and you need to work on his fine motors as well. And I don't know the other things, so I can't really tell you that you do this particular activity and it will be sorted. Okay. So work on his gross spine, eye, hand, bilateral, everything. Okay, so everyone, thank you very much for joining.
Ma'am, just one last thing. Ma'am, Shani's mother, just one last guidance that when she holds the pencil, ma'am, her hands move like this and then the pencil comes out forward. It slips from her hand.
Yes.
So she's writing, she can join the picture, but she's turning 6 years next month, but she cannot write independently still. So whenever she holds, I have all these
problems. That is the problem of wrist extension and flexion. Okay, so you need to work on the wrist stability of the child.
Wrist stability?
Yes. Wrist extension and wrist stability. Ma'am, we cannot really discuss it here. I'm really sorry. I'm cutting you short.
Is it alright to tie half kg weights while writing in her hand? Before
how will that? It will just give you a temporary extension because the child cannot flex. That is not giving you the strength here. Okay, it is like you put a plaster here, just like that. Why not build the strength in the child? So focus on the strengthening activities rather than going for the supportive aids.
Ma'am, can I ask last question, please?
Ma'am, we really need to wrap up. I'm having a session.
I typed the message 5 minutes before, actually.
Yeah,
yes, ma'am. Actually, my son uses... he uses right hand for... all the activities, but for left hand for all the activities, but for writing he uses right hand. What should I do?
Nothing, actually nothing. He can be ambidextrous.
Okay, is it okay to go with both the hands?
It is okay. Very few, very rare people do that because usually hand dominance develops by 6 to 7 years. Either his hand dominance has not developed or he is ambidextrous.
Okay.
Okay.
So okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Okay.
All right. So thank you everybody for joining it. And I hope it was helpful. Thank you, Geetu ma'am. See you everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.